endless way. And I really can't take it no more. I've been by temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless. And I really can't help it. I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, can you help me? Can't take it no more. I've been finding temptations, my Lord. I'm running on restless. I said, Lord, can you help me? I've never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. To be long, you help me. I said, Lord, can you help me?
Thank you, Larry. It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look live there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Today, it's a Week 9 matchup set to go here between the Denver Broncos and the Philadelphia Eagles. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. So now here comes the Eagles offense as they get ready to take over. The MVP of Super Bowl 47 leading his crew out there from Delaware, it's Joe Flacco.
And I'll bet right now it's just one thought in his mind.
Win the game.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, without a doubt. He played pretty well. I mean, he didn't turn over the ball in terms of interceptions,
no,
right?
Two touchdown passes
last week.
Two
touchdown passes, but when your team doesn't win, that's just hollow. And the best quarterbacks don't care about anything but whether or not their team won.
And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Partner, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks. First down, here's the run with Martin. And he'll get across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Here we go with second and 7. A break from the ground game here. Flacco. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Seven yards remaining here on third down. Flacco from the gun. And that is incomplete. But not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
Yeah, last week in the loss, 5 punts as he gets this one away. Had a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. They'll bring one of the tight ends in motion left. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. He'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 23. second down following the run. Now Newton. And he fires one that's intercepted. It's Jabril Peppers, the rookie from Michigan. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick six TD.
That was an interception, but on the field, the guys who are picking it off, they're not saying that. What word are they using? It's OSCE. That means catch the ball and go the other way.
That's your vernacular. I've never heard anybody say OSCE.
Ask around. They'll tell you.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. And Denver getting set to take the field. Coming off the pick six, it's Newton. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And they'll get him down here at the 23. The first down screen pass, good for 5. On second down, here's Newton. Pushing him away.
Popped it right out there.
And he'll score! Touchdown, Eagles! And this defense looking like they have come to play the pick six, and just like that, it's 13-0 early on.
Well, go back with me to our training camp visit. What do we hear during these drills? Oh,
pass!
Ball! Ball's in the air!
And then my favorite,
OSCE! That's the interception. That means everybody finds someone to block, block them legally, stay on your feet, and they get it done. Touchdown!
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll be out of bounds here, a yard shy of the 25 of the 24. Getting set to go again here. Cam Newton marches back onto the field. Bottom line, he's got to figure things out. He's completed 3 passes, but 2 of them have been to the wrong team so far.
And when we talk about the best quarterbacks, we're usually talking about touchdown to interception ratio, aren't we? And 2-1 is acceptable, but the top line guys, 3-1 or better is what they're looking for. Now we're talking about interceptions versus completions. That's not a ratio should ever be in any discussion.
Give them 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
And he's going to get about 7 yards on that one, up to around the 33.
That was a good run, and it got to the second level. And what I mean by that is that's where the linebackers usually play, first level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position end up making the tackle, and oftentimes we call them a hybrid, combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop.
No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up 4th down.
4th and short, partner. I mean, this would be a really risky call. Here we are in the first quarter.
On your own side of the field.
But, boy, what a tone setter that would be to go for it and get it, wouldn't it?
You're gritty today. I like it.
I'm feeling it.
They'll try and run for Lejanovich. And he will have a 1st down as they get him to the ground at the 37. 4 yards on the pickup, and they're able to convert here on 4th and inches.
Hey, 4th and inches. Why let your quarterback try and sneak for it? Give it to the guys born to fight for those tough yards. It's a fullback dive, and he just makes sure he's secure.
Pressure comes, and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Brandon Graham in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
And that one is incomplete. And it also concludes corner number one. They do, however, have a tough third and long coming up. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. Third and long, it's Newton. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
Dixon, the punter, is on as he sends it away. Sproles, the return. Still fighting for more. Darren Sproles. And he takes it all the way, but there is a flag down, so hold the celebration. This one's coming back. So a special teams mistake on a long punt return.
And think about the momentum that leaks out after that play, right? It's built up, terrific return, everyone's excited, but that flag on the ground can bring it way, way back.
Now a play fake here on first down. They shakes him off, but in the end, the pressure too great, and he goes down. Shane Ray coming in from that outside linebacker spot to bury him for a loss of 7.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
Yeah, blink of an eye. That happened fast and a big sack. On second down, Martin. And down he goes just beyond the 35. And that pretty move got him some extra space to run. 8 yards here, so that gets him back within striking distance. And now it's third down.
Good, strong run against the 3-4 set. And that 3-4... you've got to have your guys up front eat up a lot of blocks. The guy playing over the center, the nose, he usually has to take on double teams. But when you're able to successfully move him, you're often able to get some yardage. And that's when linebackers have to clean up and make tackles.
And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up. Because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun. And they missed an opportunity.
And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this will carry out of bounds. Where are they going to spot it now? At about the 18-yard line, it looks like. Reminder later tonight, a good one down in Miami. It'll be the Raiders and the Dolphins. A lot of playoff history between those two in the 70s.
Yeah, there sure is.
And then tomorrow night, we wrap up Week 9, the unofficial halfway point of the season with the Lions and Packers from Lambeau. On first down, it's Newton. And look at this. Cam Newton intercepted a third time. Read it well, and it's picked. And they're going to take over right there at the 22-yard line.
And that's now the second time he's picked off a pass here in the first half alone. Again, another great read defensively. And you just see him get in the right position to make the play and get his guys the football back.
They go play action here on first down. His throw caught right around the 6. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. They've made goal line offense a priority on the practice field this week. This is exactly the situation they've been prepping for. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Every year I go to the combine, I marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs, and let's face it, they know how to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
Flacco looks to throw. This is caught, and he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. The catch good for 6 yards, but now it's third and goal.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Definitely be a disappointment to come out of this starting position with just 3 points. They need to try to dial something up now, third and 10. They'll run for it with Martin. No gain on the play, and what to do now on fourth and goal.
Now, this feels like old school football because this has turned into a good old fashioned goal line stand. So on offense, what do you do now? Do you decide to run it or throw it if you go for it on fourth down?
And Sturgis able to knock it through, and the lead will grow. It's now 17-0. So they take it all the way to the 1 yard line, but in the end, they opt for three.
I know if this was a video game, they never would have gone for the field goal because, Brandon, who kicks field goals in video games? But you've got to make sure you get points. And that was as easy a three as you can get.
You kick field goals in video games. That's who kicks field goals in video games. Cam Newton getting ready to go again on offense. He struggled. His team has struggled. You talked to me a lot about looking to your leaders. Maybe it's time for him to put his mark on this game.
Agreed. And how that has to happen is somehow he's got to flush out everything that's happened so far and almost start over and get back to that confident level and know that he can play the game, because so far this has been a real struggle.
Yeah, absolutely. He's got the interceptions, trying to turn it around. Remain here in the first half. We'll come back to Philadelphia after this. A reminder that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll check in with Larry Ridley in Orlando with highlights and analysis of this first half of play.
And I'm going to check in with a heater.
I'm going to be right there with you, partner. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. Denver has a first down on the 15-yard play.
Thus far, it hasn't been a real fun half for them, but a play like that, that may get them off the schneid a little bit, get them loosened up and moving.
Kind of seems like they've been sleepwalking and still sitting on 0 points.
And it's not always making an adjustment. Sometimes it's just going back to what you know can work and finally getting it done.
On first down, Newton. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Brandon Graham. And that's sack number 12 for him on the year.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Off play action. Newton. Oh, look at Thomas wide open. The 30, 20, and all the way home for a Broncos score. Demaryius Thomas, 81 yards. And the Broncos get a bit closer.
Partner, you know what the real key is to stopping a good passing attack?
You tell me.
Being able to tackle as soon as a guy catches the football.
Didn't work out there.
No, because when you give up the big run after catch, the rack yardage, that puts your defense in a big-time stressful position.
A lot of rack yardage and a touchdown there on the big play. So that drive spanned 5 plays, and it culminates in a touchdown by the Broncos. Now McManus on to kick this one off. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it's a second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, a ball may come your way.
Here's Flacco, drops it off to Martin, and he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. First and 10, and Flacco looking to throw. And this is Ertz with it, right side. That one goes for 24 yards.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one. And that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. Flacco, Jeffrey with a catch left side. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. A very solid gain of 27. Throwing here on first down, Flacco. That's complete right around the 8. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Once more, it's Flacco. And that is caught. It's Aguilar for the Eagle touchdown. Nelson Aguilar in the final seconds of the first half. And the Eagles add 6 to their lead.
And that's a lead that excites a team as they head into the half. Good way to finish things off.
Yeah, able to extend that lead, and you always say it, that can totally change the complexion of half number 2.
Yeah, it changes your morale, changes your outlook. But even before that, let's see if they decide to kind of squib kick or what they're going to do on the kickoff, because you don't want to give up a big play right before the half ends.
Good point. Sturgis out now to kick this one off. This one fielded at the 5. A second quarter score from down in Houston. And the early going, it's the Texans out in front. And we'll keep you abreast of how that one shakes out.
Thanks, Brandon. And welcome to the EA Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Eagles are up right now and are looking to keep up the pressure moving forward. The Broncos didn't play their best, and they'll need to be up.
We now proceed to the start of the second half. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This is taken at his 4. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Set to go again here. Cam Newton marches back onto the field. And he's looking to take much better care of the football here in half 2 after 3 first half interceptions.
We don't have to just look strictly at the numbers here. You know what else happens to a team when you turn it over 3 times like that? It erodes confidence in you. And it erodes confidence in the offense. And now you have the defensive guys looking over and saying, what is going on here? And instead of playing for the team, they're playing angry and mad at their teammates. I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized. Steps away to his left, and he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Newton able to use those legs and get past the marker to pick up the first.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got him.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Nate Stupar coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Here's Newton now on second down. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off with great anticipation. This has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And it'll bring up a second and 13. Flacco from midfield. Jeffrey reels it in over the middle. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. Elsewhere, a third quarter score from NRG Stadium in Houston. Now the Broncos offense, they get set to head back onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Again, and a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down. Not the start to the drive they were looking for. That run doesn't do much at all.
No, not at all, and it leaves them with third and long. And you know, this is the time of game where these drives really, really start to matter. They've got to make some moves.
And he hits his man on the out route, Demaryius Thomas. Denver has the first down. The play going for 15 yards.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
A good pickup there on first as the screen pass gets him 8.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's the Broncos trailing, but they do have possession of the football as we begin quarter number 4. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They fake the give, Newton. And nearly another interception. They've been around the ball all game.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Here's Newton. A bullet throw, but incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And they're going to try the screen. It's complete. And unable to break away. They stop him a few yards shy. Gary Kubiak's guys denied on fourth down. And the Eagles defense able to hold. They start the drive with Martin. And he's not even going to get back to the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythemo Bagley, says
he'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack. Todd Davis, tough to handle on that blitz. He gets him for a loss of five.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the... offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
Now it's the all-purpose back. This is Darren Sproles. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down. Here's Donnie Jones now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Now this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. Down throw for Newton. And nearly another interception. They've been around the ball all game.
Trying to decipher what's going on out there because I don't know if he's just getting bad reads. I don't know if the defense is confusing him. I don't know if he just has, you know, bad info and intel before he snaps the ball. But he's made some pretty bad decisions with the football lately.
Yeah, several bad decisions on the interceptions he's thrown in. Frankly, that should have been another pick right there. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Now it's Newton. That's to his rookie tight end, Jake Butt. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. And they'll get nine there as that sets him up better for third down. Those short little routes probably going to be open. The defense, they'll let those happen, especially when they can make an inbounds tackle.
Yeah, where's Coach Madden when you need him? He always talked about taking what the defense gives you, but sometimes you have to know when you have to take more. That was one of those situations.
They get nine out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores, want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
Newton on first down. Screen play, Anderson. And some space here. That burst good for 20 and a first down. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
Now a play fake, and it's Newton. Rolling to his left. There he goes inside the 30. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Now Newton on first down. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. Eventually wrangled down before reaching the 20, but a strong run. The first down screen pass, good for 5. The throw on second down is Newton. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. The Broncos on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This will be 3rd and 5. From the gun, here's Newton. And Fowler's got it. And he'll be out of bounds all the way down at the 5-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Again, Newton. And this is caught for a Bronco touchdown. Virgil Green, his 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Broncos cut into that lead.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably hoping for a 1-to-5-play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-to-5-play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like... Yeah, you know,
doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
Fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. They run again on first down, Martin. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Decent chunk of yardage still left here, 2nd and 7. They run the counter with Martin, and he stopped immediately there. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. The Eagles on third down, a pretty woeful 0-for-5 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. Setting to throw, Flacco. Aguilar has it. And he gets the first down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Martin. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Doug Martin, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Eagles add on to their lead. Trying to bust out of that losing funk, and these fans have to like this. And all right, fellas, this is more like it.
And I know that if this holds up after the game, they're going to give the fans a lot of credit being at home, getting the support. But you and I both know it goes deeper than that. They had to get it together in their own facility, look each other in the eye and say, okay, what's it going to take to break this losing streak? And they really came together with a good week of practice.
Returning it, Carlos Henderson. They're on to the fourth quarter now, by the way, at Bank of America Stadium in Carolina. And it was the Panthers that wound up winning that one. A victory there would mean their sixth on the year. And coming out now, the Broncos. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge. And someone said, Coach, what do you want to call? He just waved a hand like, who cares? Let's go out of here and do something some other time. But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. Again, they'll run with Freeman. Freeman a first down and more. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That good for 19 and a first down.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other bats in the league.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. On second down, Freeman. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. And Charles, you know what coaches always tell us. We want to win our home games. That much we know. We want to protect our home turf.
I come here today to talk about how I feel. And I feel like that we are treated differently than other people. And I don't like how we're treated. And just because of us doesn't mean anything to me. It's just...